What do you mean my cards were declined? Try it again.
Buy me Prada.
No, no, no.
Balenciaga.
No, no, no.
Son, you know, once you start, there's no going back.
I know.
This means total commitment. Once you begin the path, there is no leaving the path. Are you sure you're ready for that?
The rain, it ain't permanent. And soon, we'll be dancing in the sun. We'll be dancing in the sun. I'ma sing your song together. I'ma sing your song together.
Oh, your beauty is destroyed.
Hotcha! Bimo, how do I look?
Like the devil!
My name is Gabe and this is my voice, One Day on T.
It is time for the 2-week update on T. My name is Gabe and this is my voice, 3 weeks on T.
My name is Gabe and this is my voice, 5 weeks on T.
My name is Gabe and this is my voice, 7 weeks on T.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 2 months on T.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 3 months on T.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 4 months on T.
This is my voice and my face, 5 months on T.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 6 months on T.
Hey guys, so my name is Gabe, I am 7 months on T today.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 8 months on T.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 9 months on T.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 10 months on T.
My name is Gabe, and this is my voice, 11 months on T.
This one's for you.
All the pretty girls walk like this, 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 this. Pretty girls walk like this, 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 this. All the pretty girls walk like big boss bitch. Pull up in the vet, flooded out my wrist with some ice around my neck. Shitting on my ex, on to the next. He know this pussy good cause he always come back. I like diamonds.
Solid question. So I'm trans, right? I've
literally cut off my tits. I got a double mastectomy, top surgery-wise. I've gotten a hysterectomy, and then lastly, I plan on going through bottom surgery, getting a skin graft off my arm to get a dick down below. Now understand, when I grew up female, I cross-dressed, so I was literally presenting and dressing as a boy when I was younger. I feel like this is where a lot of people don't truly understand, like, why people are trans in a way. It's like a lot deeper than just your looks. It's all about how you're feeling internally and how your mind is connecting with how your body's feeling. So yeah, cross-dressing as a female, it only did so much in regards to happiness for myself. But deep down, I knew there was something else that I needed. There was something more that I wanted. And it was definitely like what I've been through in regards to the changes and just my gender-affirming care that I get from my surgeries.
You have to treat a car like you treat a woman.
Go on.
No.
It was in fact mental illness. I was not trans. This just goes to show you, it's a fucking TikTok trend. It is.
No, it was a TikTok trend for you. Why do certain detransitioners feel the need to speak for trans people as if we have the same experience? We don't. And you wouldn't believe how insulting it is for you to come online and say that being trans is a TikTok trend when it may be for you, but for some of us, it's real. I'm fully supportive if you want to detransition. You know, you found yourself, it's your own journey. What I don't support is you coming online and claiming being trans is a TikTok trend. That I do not agree with. If you felt comfortable enough to say that, then that means you have zero understanding of the struggles trans people go through on a daily basis, because you'd know that none of those struggles would be considered trendy. So I hope you reflect and think before you speak online, really.
So today marks the third year of me being post-op surgery. 3 years ago today, so here's a few things I wish I knew that no one told me. So first, before I go on that tangent, I'm going to tell you what I got. Double incision, as you can tell by like my scars underneath. I was eligible for keyhole, but which is when they just go like around your nipple. But the reason I didn't go for that is because you can get like loose skin and it just like looks a little weird, so I didn't mind having scars, so that's why I got double incision. Okay, so first thing I wish I knew, which I already did, but I wish someone told me about it, was if you're gonna get top surgery and you have the ability to work out, try to work out your chest as much as you can, because it just makes the surgery go a lot smoother, because the less fat you have there, the less they have to do. My surgery was only like an hour and a half, barely even that, because I burned a decent amount of the fat there. They still have to get rid of the breast tissue, of course, but the fat's not there, so definitely do that first. Also, you need to plan where you want your fucking nipples to go. They'll draw them on, and you can be like, no, I want them a bit higher, or I want them a bit closer together. So, like, have an idea of, like, where you want your chest to, like, sit. Because they're going to ask you. And if you don't know, they're going to just draw something and hope to God you like it. Another one is, I still can't feel my nipples, and it's been 3 years. Like, I got mine, they took them off, put them back on. A little gross to think about, but is what it is. And I still can't feel them. Like, it's like, it doesn't feel like my skin, if that makes sense. It's kind of trippy, but, yeah. Another one is, my recovery was so difficult, only because I like to move. I like to get up and, like, do things, go work out, go climb, things like that. And I couldn't do that for, like, 3 or 4 weeks, because you're, like, not allowed to raise your arms at all. So that drove me insane. Yeah. Also, my sister had to sponge bathe me because I was not able to... You can't lift your arms up at all. At all. So I couldn't even, like, do this. So I would just stand there and my sister would get a sponge and just scrub me every few days. So, a little demoralizing. Also, the first time you take your shirt off in public, you're like, this feels so wrong. Like, it feels, like, not allowed, even though you don't got tits no more. So... be prepared to be like, is anyone looking at me? And you're like taking off your shirt for the first time. But now I try not to wear a shirt like at all, because why would I want to wear one when I have designer nips to show off?
I
I think I might be a man, you guys.
Yep. Yes, you are.
Bro, tell me something I don't know. I've been bleeding like Niagara Falls for the last fucking 5 days. Because I've got a fanny. Doesn't make me any less of a man though, does it? I mean, I'm fundraising for my cock. I can choose my size, but I guarantee it still won't be as big as the one in your head.
If I could be anybody, dead or alive, I would want to be my dad in 1985.
Whoa! Rock on, freaky bro! Yeah.
That's because I'm testosterone deficient. Because I was born a chick.
Hi, my name is Ains. I use he, him pronouns, and this is my first day on testosterone. Today is my fourth week on T.
So, even though I'm like 7.5 weeks on T,
it's been 11 weeks on T.
And this is my fourth month on testosterone.
I'm gonna make a video of my T shot routine.
So I am 24 weeks on T.
I have two things to say about testosterone right now.
And for reference, I'm about to be 9 months on testosterone.
Hey, it has now been 10 months on testosterone, and this is my voice. I'm also gonna talk a little bit about the most recent changes that I've experienced. Things that I feel like wait until a little bit later, like close to your 1 year mark, or at least that's how it's happened for me. So I've been getting a lot of like cystic acne, especially around here right now. And it has more to do with like ingrown, they're more ingrown hairs than it is cystic acne, because like my facial hair is like starting to come in. So like around my mustache and my beard, I've been getting cystic acne. My hair had slowly gotten curlier, but in the last like month it's like really ramped up and gotten a lot curlier. Like I have like ringlets in the back and stuff like that, so that's really fun. My body hair has gotten significantly darker in the last month, which is like absolutely crazy. And my favorite thing is that my voice has like settled a bit, so like I can sing more and my voice doesn't crack as much. When I get excited, my voice doesn't crack. But yeah, those are all of my exciting tea updates. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you.